Hello students, today we will see, we will continue with the one dimensional potential. So we have seen Schrodinger's equation is xi is equal to e psi, where a wave function that describes the partial and time dependent part is psi of x comma t. So the psi of x which we have observed here, which is nothing but the you can say a kinetic energy part plus potential energy part, that gives us total energy. So this h contains kinetic energy plus potential energy part. The constraints on psi of x must satisfy the, you can say there are few restrictions on psi of x which that psi of x must satisfy. That is the existence of derivatives. That means psi of x, the derivative of the psi of x must be existing. If derivative of a psi of x is existing, then that this implies it is a continuous function. Then it should satisfy the boundary conditions at the interface. And finally, the you can say we will solve by using this, we have solved the one dimensional potential well. So boundary conditions are there. We have seen these boundary conditions as psi n of x which is equal to 0 at interface, so that there should be, you can say, in first and third region, first and second region, the wave function should be continuous. Then if this is the case, we can say the wave function as sin of x is equal to a sin n pi upon l into x, where so x is between 0 to l. That also we have seen. Now if this is the case, this is our wave function. If we try to plot this wave function in, you can say, potential well, so for n is equal to 1 we have wave function which is something like this. Then for n is equal to 2 we have wave function which is like this, and for n is equal to 3 you can see this pinkish color curve. So this is the form of wave function. All wave functions will start from 0 and it will end at 0 in between this potential well. So here v of x is equal to infinite in this region. So v of x is equal to 0, v of x is equal to 0 in this middle region, and v of x is equal to infinite in this region. Wave function here, it is sine of x is equal to 0, and here psi n of x which is equal to 0, but in between this is the wave function. Now if we try to plot the energy eigenvalues, we can write the energy eigenvalues. So we have written the energy eigenvalues. En is equal to h cross square pi square n square upon twice ml square. If we substitute the value of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So depending on that, you can write the different energy eigenvalues. So let's say E1. Okay, so E1 is equal to what is that? H cross square pi square n is value when n is equal to 1, that's why n square is equal to 1, divided by twice ml square. Okay, so this is the ground state energy eigenvalue. So it is written here. So this is E1. Similarly, E2 will be 4 times of, so this is E2. E2 will be n square, n is equal to 2. So E2 will be 4 times E1. Okay, because n square value n is equal to 2, if we put the value 2, 2 square is 4, so 4 e1, and then e3, that will be e3 will be equal to, e3 will be 9 times e1. Okay, so in units of e1 it is 1 e1, it is 4 e1, this is 9 e1. Like this way we have infinite potential energy eigenvalues. Let's say e4 is there, so e4 is, then e4 will be equal to, this is e3, E4 will be 16 times E1. Like this way we can plot the energy eigenvalues in this potential wave. So the particle in a box, that is particle of mass m confined in a region between 0 to L, the potential energy is 0 inside the box and infinite outside the box. The equation inside the box will be same as for the particle V of x is equal to 0, but it has infinite total energy, then it cannot exist outside the box. This changes the solution due to the boundary condition. So the particle in a box, its solution can, we can also write the solution like this, and the solution is sin of x is equal to a1 e raised to ikx plus a2 into e raised to minus ikx. So which we can also write as a1 plus a2 into cos kx plus I times a1 minus a2 sin kx. So we can put these things So energy eigenvalues we can write as E is equal to P square upon twice M is equal to H cross square K square upon twice M, which is nothing but N square pi square H cross square upon twice ML square. So here the first wave function is written like this, second wave function is like this, third, fourth, fifth, these are the wave functions according to the value of N that will change. And similarly, their energy eigenvalues we can plot on the y-axis, and there is nothing on the x-axis, but in order to get the feeling of how these energies are differing, we can just make tick over here to show that there is a difference in the energy eigenvalues. But so n is equal to 1 corresponding to E1, that is h cross square pi square upon twice ml square, and this is 4 times, this is 9 times, this is 16, then 25, then it will be 36 times, like this way energy eigenvalues will be there. For example, there will be small question that will be asked. For example, what is the ratio of energy eigenvalues, let's say third energy eigenvalues E3 and E1. So we have to just calculate the energy eigenvalues, 9 E1 divided by just E1, so that is 9 is to 1. So such questions will be asked in different examinations. Here I have just given one example. They may ask what is the ratio of, you can say, second excited state and ground state. So first excited state is for n is equal to 2, and second excited state is for n is equal to 3, and ground state is n is equal to 1. So same, we will get the ratio 9 is to 1 in that case also. So we will move forward. So here we have just shown these wave functions, and there is one important part, the probability, you can say distribution function, that psi star into psi. So note that the view of matter as waves leads to directly to the idea of quantization of energy levels. The figure at right shows the first three stationary states wave functions, psi x for the particle in a box, that is top view, and the associated probability distribution function, the psi star psi, that means mod of psi square, it is shown in the bottom. There are locations where there is zero probability of finding the particle. What about the constant C in our solution sine of x? So we have already calculated sine of x, now this constant C, but here C, the probability of finding the particle at this point, psi wave function becomes zero, finding the particle at the, you can say in the middle, you can say it is maximum. So psi star psi gives the probability of occurrence of a particle. So here probability of finding the particle is less, it is increasing, at this point it is maximum, and it becomes very very less at the on the right hand side, so it is symmetric. Similarly, in the second case, if the particle is in the first excited state or n is equal to 2 state, this is ground state, so n is equal to 2 is first excited state, so it will be probability of occurrence will increase, and at this point at the center the probability of finding the particle is zero, and it will symmetrically it will increase here and here. So like this way, wherever it is higher value, that means at the higher position the probability of finding the particle is more. So in classical mechanics we were assuming that the probability of finding the particle is uniform throughout this, you can say, region, but it is not so quantum mechanically. That is the important thing. So wave function must be normalized so that the integral of the probability density function psi star psi square over the over all x equal to 1, which means there is 100% probability of finding the particle somewhere. We can evaluate this using the identity sin square theta is equal to 1 by 2, 1 minus cos 2 theta, that is the identity that we will use to get the c is equal to 2 by l raised to 1 half or root 2 by l. So the final normalization solution is then becomes like this. So we have already seen the probability of finding the particle between minus infinity to plus infinity is it is equal to between the minus infinity to plus infinity is psi star psi, that is nothing but, so we have seen already, minus infinity to plus infinity, so probability of finding the particle psi star psi of x, okay, of x dx, this is equal to this, okay, so which is always equal to 0 to VL, and psi of x or psi star, okay, psi star x psi xx dx is equal to 1, because between minus infinity to 0 and from L to infinity the probability of finding the particle is 0, because wave function value is equal to 0 in these regions. So if you use that, we will get this equation. So but we know that the, you can say, the value of c square we can find. Okay, so by using this integral we can find the value of c, which is equal to root 2 by n, and the final wave function becomes this, which we have. Okay, so clearly this, you can say, wave function. Okay, so final wave function I can write as sine of x is equal to root 2 by l into sine n pi x upon l. Okay, and this is the energy eigenvalues corresponding to different you can say n. So depending on the value of n, this changes. So this is very important equations. So there are a few questions that I can ask based on this exercise. So first, which of the following hypothetical wave function is acceptable for the particle in some realistic potential V of x? So we have first wave function, which is like here, it is like a straight line. In the second case, it is symmetric, and in third case, there is a sharp edge over here. Okay, so in the first case, because of this part, it is not acceptable, because if I see at this point, it is continuous, but the derivative at this point is like this, and derivative at this point is like this, which is not equal at this point. So derivative becomes discontinuous at this point, and here also derivative becomes discontinuous at this point. And there are many other reasons also. So in first case, psi of x is not continuous at x is equal to 0. Okay, so d psi upon dx, this is not defined at this first point. So if it is, okay, if something is a function, so at each and every x, there won't, there may be only one or one, only one value should be there, but at this point there are many values corresponding to this x, so this wave function is not acceptable. Then in second case, both psi of x and d psi upon dx, that is derivative of psi, is defined, that's why it is acceptable wave function. And in third case, d psi upon dx is not continuous at this point, because at this, if I come from this side, the derivative is like this. If I come from this side, derivative is like this. So at same point, values of the derivative will be different. That's why derivative is not continuous at the x is equal to 0. Now that's why that is the case. In second case, which of the following wave function corresponds to the particle more likely to be found on the left side? So if the particle is to be found on the left side, then psi star psi, okay, so this must be higher on the left hand side. So if I find the this first wave function is clearly a symmetric wave function, second is also quite symmetric, and third is also quite symmetric. Okay, so if I see the solution, so none of them is acceptable wave function, that is the solution. It is because A is clearly symmetric. In B case, okay, in this case also, and in this case also, we get psi star psi like this, because square of this will be like this, and square of this negative quantity will be a positive quantity, which will be like this. Okay, here negative quantity square will be positive, and this positive quantity square will be again positive. That's why any of these, you can say psi of x, will not be an acceptable wave function. Then, okay, so often what we measure in an experiment is the probability density, that is psi of x mod of psi of x square. The sine of x is given, and this wave function, that is also given. Okay, so here we have given the wave function corresponding to, so let's say this is psi of x, this is for n is equal to 1, this is n is equal to 2, this is for n is equal to 3, and its corresponding wave functions. So see, if this is let's say height is this much, this height is slightly higher. Okay, so if the so this height and this height is not same. Okay, so height will change. Here on the left hand side, we have wave function like this, corresponding, you can say, wave function's probability is higher at the middle point, where probability of occurrence is zero here. So it becomes zero at this point, psi star psi, that is psi square, it becomes zero, and similarly for the third case. Then probability and normalization. Similarly, we have seen one more approach to solve the same case, and we have obtained the value of A, which is equal to 2 by L. Okay, so this is one of the way. So okay, so now based on that, we will solve two, three more problems. which of the which has the more, we can say, bound state. That is the first case, first problem. Particle in finite well, particle in infinite well, both have the same bound states. But we will see the solutions to this, because if particle is in infinite potential well, then there are infinite number of bound states. If it is, let's say, particle is in finite state like this. Okay, so if this is the potential is defined, V of x is equal, let's say, V0, some potential. Here, let's say, V of x is equal to 0 in between, and V of x is equal, let's say, V0. V0 is some finite quantity. So only bound states are up to this. So let's say I have some energy, energy of the particle. If it is, let's say, if energy of the particle is less than V0, in that case only it is bound state. So let's say first wave function will be like this, second wave function will be like this. Okay, so the, I will have different wave functions up to this point, but after that, whatever energy, if E is greater than V0, in that case I will have we can say unbound states of the energy eigenvalues. So so in case of infinite potential well, we have already seen, okay, because this potential is infinite. So for n is equal to n is equal to infinite, let's say for n is equal to 1, it is like this. N is equal to 2, it is like this. Okay, n is equal to 3, it is like this. Okay, so we have seen these wave functions. It will be up to infinity because there is no end, because it is up to infinity. That's why particle in an infinite well has a more bound states. In second case, particle in finite square well, which has the following, okay, which of the following will decrease the number of bound states? Okay, I think you have not studied the finite potential well, but for this problem, all these three answers will be accepted, because with decrease in the potential depth, well of the depth, you can say decrease well depth, the you can say there will be decrease in the number of bound state, decrease in the well width, there will be decrease in the number of bound states, and in decrease in m, that is the mass of the particle, in that case also there will be decrease in the you can say bound state. Compare the energy energy eigenvalues of one finite state, ground state energy of finite, you can say, potential well, of the lowest states of the finite, you can say, well, with the energy of the ground state of infinite potential well, lowest states of the infinite well of the same width. Means, what is the question? Let's say I have a finite potential well like this, of let's say 0 to L length, and I have infinite potential well of same width. So width is 0 to L. Okay, so let's say its ground state energy is, let's say, E1, that is ground state energy of finite. Okay, and its, let's say, ground state energy is there, E1 of infinite. So we have a question in finite. Okay, so we have a question whether this energy, ground state energy of finite or ground state energy of infinite will be higher. So for that purpose, study the, you can say, finite potential well also, but which we have not studied here. So in that case also, the finite potential well has lower ground state energy as compared to infinite potential energy. Okay, so which has more bound state, that is for particle in infinite well. So in for second case, all three, for the particle in a finite square well, which of the following will decrease the number of bound state? It has for these three cases, the bound state will decrease. And if we compare the ground state energy eigenvalue of the finite and infinite potential well, the ground state energy for the infinite potential will be higher, less than ground state energy of infinite potential well. Then, okay, so that is given here, a solution is given here. So with this, we will stop here. Thank you for watching this video.